Yeah. After texting you almost every day for the past 365 days,
it's true,
your day, your big day is finally almost here. Which reminds me.
Yeah.
I have texted again for almost an entire year with a countdown because she said I wouldn't do it. And I had to do my best to prove her wrong. Since your wedding day is only a couple of days away, it makes me reminisce about when I first was told about you. 9 years ago, Gab and I were in the parking lot of Starbucks the weekend after she went to a party with her friend Jimmy. Gab was getting ready to become a cool college girl while I was going into sophomore year of high school. We chatted about her going into college soon, and then Gab said, "Hey, so remember that guy I went on a date with that works at Wawa?" She was not referring to
him. Oh.
He's attractive and all, but that party went to last weekend, I met this other guy. I cut her off real fast and I said, "Girl, you better decide right now who you're gonna go on a date with, because right now you're the worst and I'm judging you." She said, "I know, stop." "But I don't know what to do." I said, well, you can't even do it simultaneously. To which she said, and of course she said this, "Well, duh, that guy at Wawa is a hot Wawa guy, but the one I met last weekend, he's a forever kind of guy, and he's so funny." The next week, the next week, I met this bushy haired ginger guy that walked onto Digby Drive, and now he's been here for 9 years. Gab, you made the best decision of your life after you almost made the worst decision of your life. Good job, bestie Bill. Joe, the fact that you and Gab have been dating and engaged for 9 years is so wonderfully crazy. During the first little while of you guys dating, I didn't see much of you because she didn't want her three brothers to weird you out and make you run away. However, for roughly 8 years or more, I can't count the amount of times we've hung out and you made us all pee ourselves laughing, played that music game where you play that 1 second of a song and then you would know every damn song immediately, played Outback games and you would win cornhole basically every time. We played drinking games and you were the life of the party. Slowly but surely, you became my third brother. Thank you for making my sister laugh, for being the practical person in the room, for mediating every little argument Gab throws at you. Thank you for being the person we all need in our lives, but especially Gab's number one fan. And most importantly, thank you for being my brother.
Hi everyone. For anybody that doesn't know me, my name is Dugan. I am the youngest of Gab's brother, but much more importantly, I am the tallest of Gab's brothers.
Good for you.
As the youngest brother, I've had a very specific relationship with Gab. Gab is the most generous person I've ever met, and there's a pretty good chance that I have benefited from that the most. Sure, that doesn't mean that Gab pays for me much more than I pay for her, but it's much more than that. I've never seen her be selfish with her time, always sacrificing it to help someone out or be somewhere just because it makes someone's day better. Even recently, I've been going out to her and Joe's house just to hang out, mostly so me and Joe can stay up until 3 a.m. playing the song game. But no matter how tired Gab is, she tries to stay up with us. It is never successful. Gab slowly curls into a ball on the couch and then pisses out. But I'm so glad that she tries just because I'm there. Now for Joe, my Bowser Cup champion.
Yeah.
Being the youngest brother meant that Joe has had to entertain me for the last 8 or 9 or 15, whatever it is. Luckily for me though, Joe loves games probably just as much as I do. So much so that a couple of times I've been yelled at by Gab because Gab would bring Joe over and then Joe would immediately go missing into the basement to play with me for the next 4 hours. Between playing Super Mario Baseball and Strikers in my parents' basement, to being my undefeated Chesties partner out in Chicago, I can always rely on Joe to entertain me, and I hope throughout the years I've done likewise.
Certainly have. Woo!
Just one more. So on Thanksgiving, we tend to go around the room and we always say like what we're thankful for. And for my answer, I usually channel my inner Vin Diesel, a la Dom Toretto. And my answer is my family. Specifically, I want to expand on that. And as Dugan and Shane have kind of implied already, that like having Gabrielle specifically as a sister is probably one of the greatest blessings to have just in life. For as long as I can remember, we've been a team. And all four of us are a team as Marino, you know, the Marino bunch. But I can remember a time without Shane, very briefly. And as much as Dugan like despises this, there was a time before you.
That's right. That's right.
But all of my earliest memories have Gab by my side. So having known Gabrielle our whole lives, basically, I am, as the older brother, I thought that this would be a good time to air some grievances.
Oh,
and Joe, I feel like you should, you know, if you're not already aware, you should probably know before Saturday. First of all, Gab is super sensitive. Like, super sensitive.
She's
crying right now. Oh my god. You know, I've had, you know, as a kid, there was a few maybe jokes that didn't land into the room. Mom, I swear I was just joking those times. She's also a little bossy. You know, apparently she thinks because, you know, she has to remind us of important events, like tonight. And, you know, she remembers everybody's birthday that she can make all the sibling decisions, you know. And she's also been a real pain in my eye. So, Joe, just watch out to the left. But at the same time, you know, she's so sensitive because she is so caring and she's so supportive and she's bossy because we kind of need it sometimes. And doing this, that like she's probably one of the most generous people that I know. And I'm certain that probably almost all of us have some experience or know firsthand what it's like to have Gab in your corner, and it really is a gift. And so Joe, like, I know her voice, and I know, like, as the oldest brother, I'm not gonna make any threats publicly at least, but I just wanna remind you, like, that you found a really special person. And Gabrielle, I'm just glad that you found somebody that's as caring and supportive and generous for you as you are for everybody else. So.
Woo! Closing remarks.
Oh.
So, Michelle,